Students, last class we have discussed difference between accounting and auditing. As I have told you, there are 25 points which differentiates accounting and auditing. From that, in the last class we have discussed first 10 points. Those 10 points are which differentiate accounting and auditing is from meaning, timing, beginning, period, coverage, then level of detail, type of checking, focus, objective, legal status. So today's class will start with the next point, that is performed by. Okay, see, accounting is performed by accountants. Yes, for accounting, that is for recording the business transactions or day-to-day activities, accountant will be appointed. Whereas auditing is performed by qualified auditor. Okay, next comes is status. Accounting is usually carried out by an internal employee of the company, that is employee who works for the company. That person will be carrying out accounting, whereas auditing is carried out by an external person or independent agency. Next is appointment. Accountant will be appointed by the management of the company. As accountant will be the internal employee of the company, company management will appoint the accountant, whereas auditor will be appointed by the shareholders of the company or regulator. Next comes as qualification. To become an accountant, okay, a person need to be completed his graduation in commerce field, whereas some specific qualification is compulsory for an auditor, that is he should graduate from the Institute of Chartered Accountants. Next comes is remuneration type. Accountant will carry out by a company employee who gets a salary, whereas a specific auditing fees is paid to the auditor. See, as accountant will be appointed by the management, management will pay him a salary as a remuneration, whereas auditor will be paid a fees, or his remuneration will be paid in the form of fees. Okay, next is remuneration fixation, that is who will fix the remuneration for accountant as well as for the auditor. Remuneration will be fixed by the management of the company. As I have told you, accountant will be appointed by the management of the company. So remuneration, that is a salary, will be fixed by the management for the accountant, whereas auditor will be appointed by the shareholders. So his fees will be fixed by the shareholders itself. Okay, then comes the scope determination. The scope of accounting is determined by the management of the company, whereas the scope of auditing is determined by the relevant laws and the regulations. Next is necessity. How necessary accounting is and how much auditing is necessary. See, accounting is necessary for all the organization so that they can record the day-to-day or routine operations. Whereas auditing is not necessary in day-to-day operations. Auditing will be done when accounting ends, that is either half yearly or yearly. Okay, then comes as deliverables. Accounting prepares financial statements like income statement or profit and loss account, balance sheet, cash flow statement. That is what accounting delivers. It delivers financial statements. It prepares financial statements, that is transactions will be recorded in the form of financial statement, which includes income statement, profit and loss account, balance sheet, cash flow statement, fund flow statement, and so on. But auditing provides what? Audit report. And this report submission will be done to the shareholders in case of auditing. In case of accounting, report will be submitted to the management. Okay, next is guidance. accountants may make suggestions for the improvement of accounting and related activities. That is, accountant can give their suggestions for the improvement of accounting and related activities. But auditor usually does not make suggestions. Okay. If companies or shareholders or regulators ask for the suggestions from the auditor, then only he will give the suggestions. Otherwise, he will be giving his opinions. Okay. Next comes is liability. See, accountant's liability generally ends with the preparation of the accounting. Okay. Accountant is not liable for any kind of loss. Okay, his work ends with the preparation of the accounting. But whereas auditor has liability after preparation and submission of the audit report. Because on the basis of this report, shareholders will decide whether they have to invest in the company or not. Right? So it is responsibility of the auditor to go through the accounting thoroughly before giving the audit report. Okay, next comes is shareholders meetings. See, shareholders meeting, accountant does not attend the shareholders meeting unless and until he has invested in the shares of the company. Okay, otherwise he do not have responsibilities to attend the shareholders meeting. Whereas auditor may attend the shareholders meeting because the auditor will be appointed by the shareholders. Okay, next comes is professional misconduct. An accountant is not usually prosecuted for professional misconduct, whereas an auditor can be prosecuted for professional misconduct as per the applicable legal procedures. Okay, last one is removal. Accountant can be removed by the management. As accountant will be appointed by the management of the company, the management of the company will be having the right to remove the accountant. While an auditor can be removed by the shareholders. As auditor will be appointed by the shareholders or the regulators, shareholders and the regulators will be having the right to remove the auditors. Okay. So these are some of the points which differentiates accounting and auditing. If you have any doubt, please discuss and clear it. And the other things we'll discuss in the next class. Thank you.